My name is Mads Bamker from Kaizer Power Electronics, and today I would like to show you the Hameg programmable counter and timer. While I was moving, I accidentally broke one of the potentiometer knobs off the front, and while I wanted to replace it, I discovered that the potentiometers on the front end of this unit are quite special. So I did not think I would find another plastic rod that easy. But I found a quite easy fix for it that I would like to show you. And while I had the lid off the unit, I figured we could do a small walkthrough of the circuit. A quick one down of the specifications of this unit. It has a and B channel, which are rated DC 250 MHz. And then it has a C channel, which is rated up to 1.6 GHz. But as we can see on the math functions here, it is only frequency for channel C that is possible, while as all the calculations are done between channel A and B. So if I want to do any timing calculations between two signals, this can only be done up to 150 MHz. So let's go handheld and look at the front end where these potentiometers sit. Now the problem is that these small plastic bars here we have the rest of the channel A one. If I pull the whole front end out here, we can see that these potentiometers here, it has no markings, and if it has a marking, it's probably on the back side of it, which I cannot see for the PCB. So I got no idea what kind of make this is, and from a little googling and such and looking through the manual and schematics, I did not find anything. So I thought, okay, this is wasting too much time. But if we look at the back, we can see that there is a row of holes, and these actually made it possible for a simple machine screw that I filed two sides of fit right through here. And while it just needs a few insulating spaces, not likely it can actually short circuit anything anyway, but it actually makes a perfect fit and will go through the front just fine. So that was the small repair. So let's take a look at the unit's circuit. Here I have the lid off the unit. Up here we have the input board, where the front end with the BNC connectors sit here at the front. We can see here that it's quite symmetrical down the middle. There is one channel over here and another channel here. And then in the middle is the timer. First we have here a U 441, which is a matched JPET pair, which works as a differential amplifier. Next comes the FA30003, which is a intercell operation amplifier. This is a 300 MHz bandwidth with a settling time of just 20 nanoseconds, and this is where the magic happens with the fast cover rates of the counter. Then right behind it sits a quad line receiver, and then again we have a TLO82 operational amplifier, which is a mere 4 MHz. So I guess it is interleaving into 4 lines and then sampling from those 4 lines at the last amplifier, where it scales down to the whole a large area here of ICs, which is mostly quad, NOR, OR, and gates. So this probably depends on what the selection on the front is, on what math to do, how the signal is combined. Now the main processor is a Intel ADC31B. Which I'm not sure if this is a 12 or 16 MHz version, but it's an 8-bit microcontroller with 4 kilobyte of ROM. It has 32 general inputs outputs, And has two 16-bit timers and a few other things from that area. It's dated 1980 and 1989, so it has some age to it. Right above it, it has some binary counters and some octal buffers. Along, it has this ROM sitting here. Now, it does not have an external crystal, so that's why I do not know what frequency it's running at, but instead it has these 374 series ICs over here, which is two dual-bit 4-bit decay counters and a NAND gate. So this makes up the oscillator. Over here there is 374, 373, which are octal three state latch, and this is where the display information is given out to the display front that we have here. Over here is a whole row of 74 series ICs, and it actually starts out with a 555 timer IC, and this is the gate output timer. At the back of the unit here, we have a good big power supply, shielded. Over here is the general purpose input-output interface, which is a HP standard. So it can communicate over a bus with other instruments and a computer and such. Underneath it are some six BNC outputs and inputs. That's like a gate timing and channel 1 and 2 output from the behind and such. So overall there's that not very simple unit, very straightforward lines of how data is treated. But yeah, a nice unit, and I'm happy that I got it opened and cleaned up and repaired so it can return to duty. Here it is, once again running nicely. Here you can see I have 10 megahertz frequency count, comes from this synthesizer. So we can check out the period on a 10 megahertz signal. You can see that is very low, so if I try to take, for example, a 100 kilohertz signal instead, and we can see the period is around 1000 times bigger. We can also take the total input count. So this runs pretty fast, but still pretty slow for 100 kilohertz. So we can take 10 megahertz again. So that sped things up a bit. 15 megahertz. So I'm not gonna set up the big measurements and timing stuff right now, but I just want to show that it runs, and I hope you enjoyed this little small repair, small teardown, and small circuit analysis. So until next time, see ya.